Hi, I'm Dr. Daniel Levin. I'm an interventional radiologist. I've been performing uterine fibroid embolization since 2002, which is 15 years. Fibroids are benign, non-cancerous tumors of the uterus, which affect up to 50% of childbearing women. They're more common in the African-American, Asian, and Hispanic populations. There's no known cause, however, there is a genetic and a familial predisposition. There is a link between estrogen production and the growth of fibroids. Depending on their location, fibroids can cause all or any of these symptoms: heavy menstrual bleeding, pelvic pain, frequent urination, constipation, and pain during intercourse. The options for treatment of fibroids include hysterectomy, where the uterus is completely removed, myomectomy, where only some of the fibroids are removed and the uterus is put back together, endometrial ablation, that involves burning of the lining of the uterus, leuprolide treatment, which is a hormonal treatment which induces artificial menopause, and uterine fibroid embolization, which has been on the forefront in the past 20 years. Uterine fibroid embolization is a procedure whereby the fibroids, which are a hard tumor that needs blood supply to continue to live and grow, whereby the blood supply is blocked off using small little particles. Once the blood supply to the fibroids is cut off, they begin to soften, liquefy, and shrink. The embolization is targeted and specific to the arteries that feed the fibroids, such that the arteries that feed the rest of the uterine muscle remains intact and the rest of the uterus remains alive. So the particles are permanent. They don't interact with the body. They are inert, and there are no allergic reactions at all. They remain in the vessel and hopefully do not allow the blood flow to resume within the vessel for the rest of the patient's life. The major disadvantages of a hysterectomy is one, that many women wish to have to maintain their uterus even after they had born children. The other disadvantages are that it's a major abdominal incision. There's higher complication rates with that surgery compared with other less invasive procedures, and the recovery period is longer. It could be up to 6 to 8 weeks before one feels completely normal and can resume activities of daily life without feeling discomfort. Myomectomy myomectomies are really two major ones. One is that there is a significant risk of bleeding, probably between 1% and 5%, which can result in a hysterectomy, which is a higher rate when you compare to fibroid embolization, much higher rate. Additionally, there's about 25% recurrence rate of the fibroid symptoms after a myomectomy. It is slightly faster perhaps than compared to a hysterectomy, but still a much longer period of time to recover, on a number of several weeks compared to other procedures. Endometrial ablation number one does not work for all patients. And it's a procedure that, when it works, it only controls the symptoms of severe bleeding. It does not address it doesn't address the fibroids at all, and does not therefore resolve any symptoms that may be related to the fibroids that are more related to pressure and location. So leuprolide induces artificial menopause. It's basically a short-term solution, can be used up to 6 months, and that's undesirable. In addition, it can only control the symptoms of bleeding. It doesn't control the symptoms that are related to the size of the fibroids, location, and the pressure and pain symptoms that are related to that. There are several advantages to uterine fibroid embolization over the other available procedures. It's a procedure that can be done in an outpatient setting. The patient doesn't have to spend the night in the hospital. There's no abdominal incision involved. The anesthesia is moderate sedation and it's completely comfortable. In addition, the overall complication rate with uterine fibroid embolization is lower in comparison with the other procedures, the other more major surgical procedures. The recovery time for the more major abdominal procedures could be up to 6 to 8 weeks, whereas the fibroid embolization procedure, the patient can go home the same day, usually discharged within 4 to 5 hours after the procedure. And most patients within 4 days or so are back to normal. Certainly within a week, most patients can be back at work. 80 to 90% of patients experience either complete resolution of their symptoms or a major improvement in their symptoms. With regard to the heavy bleeding, most patients will have marked improvement within the first 2 months after the procedure. The symptoms that are a result of the pressure that the fibroids are applying to adjacent organs or within the uterus, such as pelvic pain, frequent urination, constipation, those symptoms might take up to 6 months to see the full extent of the recovery and the improvement. Uterine fibroid embolization is a very safe procedure with very rare complications. Most women who are candidates for myomectomy or hysterectomy are also good candidates for uterine fibroid embolization. There are also, and particularly women, who might be considered a surgical risk for a more major surgery, and therefore the less invasive procedure of UFE is quite applicable to them. The procedure should not be performed on women who have active infection or women who are currently pregnant. Certainly, the procedure should not be performed when there's a question of abnormal cells or other findings on the MRI that need further investigation. There are, however, a minority of patients who, for either because of the size of the uterus or the fibroids or the location or anatomic variation of the fibroid, may be precluded from the procedure, but these are the vast minority of the patients.